Hello. There are lots of questions from the students on use of reverse transcriptase LUF mediated isothermal amplification, that is RT-LAM, in the diagnosis of COVID-19. Well, today we will discuss RT-LAM topic and I will consider following points: introduction, general methodology, principle on which RT-LAM technique is based, comparison with RT-PCR, advantages and disadvantages, and related diagnostic kit and laboratory test for COVID-19. Since RT-PCR test for the detection of SARS-CoV-2 is expensive, it takes 3 to 4 hours and requires costly equipment like PCR amplifier. That's why the new technique RT-LAM has been introduced, which requires only 1 hour and does not require expensive equipment. RT-LAM technique is used for the amplification of RNA at isothermal temperature between 60 to 65 degrees centigrade. Hence, using an incubator or even a water bath, it is possible to carry out viral RNA multiplication process, and the end result can be observed as change in color or in the form of precipitate, or can be recorded as fluorescence or by nephelometry rate of reaction method. This viral detection method is 100% sensitive and 100% specific. Since BST DNA polymerase enzyme is used in this process to create multiple copies of cDNA of the virus, melting procedure is not required, which is required in RT-PCR method. BST DNA polymerase enzyme is stable at 65 degrees temperature and it is obtained from the thermophile Rorschach gram-positive bacteria Geobacillus stearothermophilus. It is important here again to know that RT-PCR test requires thermal cycling, cycles of heating and cooling to facilitate the viral cDNA replication. RT-LAM technique does not require these cycles and is performed at constant temperature between 60 and 65 degrees centigrade. Similarly, like RT-PCR test, in RT-LAM technique also, reverse transcriptase enzyme is used to synthesize complementary DNA, that is cDNA, from RNA sequences of the virus. This cDNA is then amplified using DNA polymerase, and 10 raised to 9 copies of cDNA are produced per hour. There is a specific requirement of the primers. Following 4 sets of LAM primers which target the viral RNA of SARS-CoV-2 in the regions of ORF1AB, S gene and N gene are required, and these are 4 sets of LAM primers: 0117, S17, N1 and N15, which target RNA coding ORF1AB spike glycoprotein and 2 regions in the nucleocapsid protein of SARS-CoV-2 respectively. Each of these 4 sets contain 6 primers. Just look at the figure on the left hand side. Now I will tell you the general methodology. First, isolation of cDNA from patient's specimen. Cycling amplification and elongation of viral RNA by RT-LAM method using following step. First step is 4 specifically designed primers recognize distinct target sequences on the template primed. The primers bind only to these sequences with high specificity. 2. Out of the 4 primers involved, 2 of them are inner primers, FIP and BIP, which are designed to synthesize new DNA strands. Next, the outer primers F3 and B3 are nil to the template strand and also generate new DNA. These primers are accompanied by DNA polymerase, which helps in strand displacement and releases the newly formed DNA strands. And 4, visual observation of turbidity or yellow color, or reading rate of reaction by exhibited fluorescence or by rate nephelometry. Now let us see how RT lamp test is performed in a laboratory to test corona infection. The test requirements are: 1. Patient's nasopharyngeal swab. 2. Test kit. It contains following various reagents: RNA extraction reagent, which contains EDTA, sodium dodecyl sulfate, triazole, chloroform, etc. Then TRIS EDTA buffer, pH 8.3, and very important, test mix, which contains DNTPs, DNAs, primer sets, reverse transcriptase, BST DNA polymerase enzyme, and RNA inhibitors. RNA free water is also required, and cybergreen or evagreen reagent. Third requirement is a centrifuge as specified for RT lamp. And fourth requirement, if necessary, for reading spectrophotometer, otherwise by visual observation also one can read the end test result. Well, procedure is like this. First step is coronavirus RNA extraction from patient's nasopharyngeal swab. This procedure is the same as RT-PCR procedure, and for that you must watch our video on RT-PCR. That also will give you idea about the difference between RT-PCR and RT-LAMP procedures. Then reverse transcriptase in the reagent converts viral RNA into cDNA, and then following reactions take place as displayed on the screen. In the first reaction, the forward inner primer F2, accompanied by reverse transcriptase, initiates the process by binding to FC, the target sequence on the 5 end of RNA template, and synthesizes a complementary DNA strand. In the second step, the forward outer F3 primer binds to specific F3C region of the template strand, and with the help of DNA polymerase simultaneously creates a new cDNA strand while displacing the previously made copy. The double-stranded DNA containing the template strand is now not needed. In the step 3, this single-stranded DNA with the loop at the 5 end serves as a template for B2, backward inner primer. B2 hybridizes to B2C region of the template DNA. DNA synthesis is now initiated, leading to the formation of a complementary strand and opening of the 5 end loop. Step 4. Now the outer primer B3 hybridizes to B3C region of the target DNA and extends, displacing the BIP linked complementary strand. This results in the formation of a dumbbell shaped DNA. Just look at the figure on the left hand side. Step 5. The DNA has a dumbbell like structure as the ends fold and self anneal as shown in the figure, and this structure becomes a stem loop when the forward inner primers FIP or backward inner primers BIP once again initiate DNA synthesis at one of the target sequence locations, and in 1 hour about 10 raised to 9 copies of cDNA are formed. It is important to note here that this test also can be performed at patient's bedside without using a spectrophotometer. The end result you can read, you can see by eyes only, and when magnesium pyrophosphate is used, precipitate is formed at the end when the test result is positive, while hydroxy naphthol blue, when it is used, then it results in a color change from violet to blue, whereas calcium induces a change from orange to yellow green. Well, now compare RT-PCR with RT-LAM procedure. PCR requires temperature cycling at various temperatures, while LAM requires single temperature. PCR requires 2 primers, LAM requires 6 primers. PCR requires 3 to 4 hours for completion, while LAM test can be completed within 1 hour. Then quantity obtained of cDNA is less in RT-PCR compared to LAM procedure. And very important, no visual detection is possible in RT-PCR, while in RT-LAM procedure it is possible to get visual detection. Today you have learned general RT-LAM methodology, principle on which RT-LAM technique is based, comparison with RT-PCR, advantages and disadvantages, and related diagnostic kit and laboratory test for COVID-19. I hope you liked this video. Next time I will get you one more educational video. Kindly don't forget to subscribe our channel and also share this video with all your friends. And don't forget to see our textbooks also for more education in medical laboratory technology.